What's up, YouTube family? What's up, world? Welcome back to another one. I'm Pastor Lee. It's Sunday. Sunday. We're coming in from Sabbath, yo. So I'm rested up really well. Sabbath is from Friday sundown to Saturday on sundown. Okay? One of the commandments that our Father gave us. And I try to go by many of the commandments to the best of my ability, yo. I'm not perfect. Only Yeshua did it right in my eyes, yo. I'm not perfect. But we're going to get into the word right now. And we're going to show you something dealing with how, okay, if you haven't already heard, brothers and sisters, and if you're still here with me right now, you haven't left, all right, there has been another shooting in, man, funny thing is, I used to work right around this place, yo, right around Antioch, Tennessee, all right? At Burnett Chapel Church of Christ in Antioch, Tennessee, 8 people have been injured so far. I mean, nobody has been confirmed dead, you know, and that's only 8 injured so far. You know, this is unfolding right now, brothers and sisters, all right? But this is the second time that this has happened recently, yo. We just had the whole Dylan Roof shooting, okay, where he ran up in there and shot and killed all those innocent people. Alright, and this is not a freaking religion problem, alright, get that out the way, man. Alright, we're going to get deep into this on something, brothers and sisters, because you want to know something? As a Christian, you are allowed to protect yourself by the word. Let's get into what the word of God says. We're going to get into what the word of God says, because as a pastor, that's what I go by, okay? You're allowed to refute, you're allowed to set things straight, and you're allowed to reprove for what? Anything you may need, right here by the word of God. You understand? By the word of our Father in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach, we're going to get into this word and see what it says about you as citizens allowed to protect yourself. Because let me tell you something, brothers and sisters, if you're still here right now, all right? If somebody would have been up in there in these situations and would have been armed, brothers and sisters, your Second Amendment right being armed, okay? Sadly, one person might have been shot in these places in Orlando. Okay, sadly, one person might have been shot in San Bernardino. Sadly, one person might have been shot in this situation right here in Antioch. And even in that situation in the church in South Carolina and many other places where this has happened. But that would have been it, because someone in there, a citizen who was armed, would have wiped them out. Just like in the Wild West days, man. You wouldn't just run up into a place shooting in the Wild West days, because you'd get chopped down. You understand? And they want to disarm us because they know that if we are disarmed, it's easier to control the people. You understand what I'm saying? You can control the people if they ain't armed. But what does the Bible say? Let's get into what the Bible says right now, y'all. We're going to get deeper into this, because I'm telling you right now, brothers and sisters, you got to arm up and you got to protect yourself. You got to protect your family, your loved ones, and you got to protect your neighbors, yo. You understand? You got to protect each other, because this is going to continue to get worse, y'all. Let's get into this. All right? All right? Let's start. Let's jump into this. Let's get into what the word says right quick, brothers and sisters. Let me fix that right quick. There we go. All right. Now, if you want to follow along with me on this, we're going to get into the book of Luke. Okay? We're going to go all the way to chapter 22, brothers and sisters. And I'm just going to give it to you right here. I'm going to give it to you hard, y'all. Okay? Now, we're going to go, we already know right above in verse 33, where it says that Jesus is talking about, you know, Peter, you're going to deny me 3 times before a rooster crows, okay? And you know what Peter said? I will never deny you. You know what I'm saying? That's not going to happen, all right? I will go to prison and I will die for you, okay? How many of us have said that? I've said that many times, yo. For real, for real. I used to didn't be that way. I was actually a Satanist at one time. I am a prodigal son, okay? I went to Wiccan, Odinism, Satanism. I was an atheist, agnostic, studied Buddhism, Confucianism, Taoism, Hinduism. I did that whole New Age Spiritism stuff. I went to all sects of Christianity, okay? Jehovah's Witnesses, Mormon, okay? Catholicism, Seventh-day Adventist, okay? Let me see, Unitarian, okay? Episcopalian, okay? Methodist. God almighty, man. Some of these freaking, you know, new age ones where it's like, come as you are, we're just going to sing and that's it. And, you know, prosperity preaching type stuff, like Joel Osteen type churches like that, yo. All right. Anyway, let's see what the word has to say, okay? Let's see what the word has to say about this, all right? Now, he says at verse 35, he also said to them, when I sent you forth without purse, food pouch, and sandals, you did not want for anything, did you? They said no. Going on to verse 36, then he said to them, but now let the one that has a purse take it up. Likewise also a food pouch, and let the one having no sword sell his outer garment and buy one. Now we're going to get back to that word sword, okay? Hold up. Stay here with me. For I tell you that this which is written must be accomplished in me, namely, quote, and he was reckoned with lawless ones, for that which concerns me is having an accomplishment. Going on to verse 38. Then they said, Lord, look, here are two swords. He said to them, it is enough. Now, what does that mean? Today's equivalent of a sword back then is arming yourself with a weapon. You understand? The vocabulary back then is not the same vocabulary as today. You got to understand, man, they're throwing all kinds of new words in the dictionary. Bay. I mean, words are being shortened just because you're lazy to say a whole word. So we're conforming to society's laziness, like that movie with Luke Wilson, Idiocracy. You ever see that movie with Luke Wilson called Idiocracy? Look it up. It's a trip. That's how society's becoming. How about that cartoon Wall-E? That's how society's becoming, y'all. People are just getting lazy, man. You just want to give everything over to computers and everything. And you want to give everything over to just, you know, being, you know, the police protecting you. And, you know, you're not having any rights. And just, hey, you know, we don't need to have any guns because guns are bad, you know. You know, it's the people behind the guns. Guns don't kill people. It's the people behind the guns that are freaking shooting people. You understand what I'm saying? I mean, that's just like blaming freaking cookies and Oreos and freaking, and, you know, all this other stuff for people having obesity and stuff like that. No, it's you eating it. I mean, I know the food is unhealthy too. Yes, okay, it is unhealthy because it's got a lot of, you know, byproducts and freaking preservatives and stuff on it. And it ain't natural. You should be eating organic. But you're still feeding that junk down your throat. But you can stop it at any time. All right, you can get on the diet and stop it. You got to have the will and you got to fight your flesh. It's hard to fight your flesh, but you got to fight your flesh, brothers and sisters. And that goes with anything. That goes with the homosexuals out there. That goes with the transgenders out there. That unless you're a hermaphrodite and you're born with both the organs and they chopped off the wrong one, honestly, and it's genetic, seriously genetic like that, you ain't got no, you like, some of these, I don't mean to get on this subject right now, yo, but seriously, there's so many things that are being given over in this world, you know, and the debauchery and this, the disgust, you know, the rappers who are actually gay and in the closet, you know, out here wearing dresses and stuff. The Bible says a man's not supposed to wear what pertaineth to a woman, and a woman's not supposed to wear what pertaineth to a man. And it even goes on in the New Testament. So I don't want to hear it. It even goes into the New Testament. It says men who sleep with men and lay with men will not inherit the kingdom of God. You understand what I'm saying? You got to fight your flesh. You can't be going, listen, just because I'm pointing out your sin doesn't mean I hate you, okay? Listen, it's a sin. It's an imperfection. You understand? You got to fight that imperfection. You got to fight those homosexual tendencies. You got to fight those tendencies to go out here and want to rob and steal people. You got to fight those tendencies to want to go out here and just beat people and just kill people. You gotta fight those tendencies to want to go out here and eat people. You gotta fight those tendencies to want to go out here and just have sex with horses and sheep. You gotta fight those tendencies to want to go out here and have sex with your own kids. You gotta fight those tendencies to want to go out here and freaking kill people. You gotta fight those tendencies to want to go out here and freaking have sex with dogs. You know, like that Whitney Wisconsin girl on YouTube. Yeah, Whitney Wisconsin. Look her up, man. Saying, you know, all the different breeds of dogs that you can have sex with and which dogs are the best lickers for the pussy and stuff like that. Look it up, y'all. This is the stuff that's being accepted on there. Dragon faced women and stuff like that. Genderless aliens. But we shouldn't do as that Aleister Crowley, do as thou wilt type thinking. That freaking Albert Pike, New World Order, do as thou wilt, mother freaking Orwellian, freaking, oh my God, utopia. Man, get off that junk, yo. Seriously, are you serious, man? Hey, I'm not gonna shut up anymore. You can get off my channel if you can't take the truth, then get out of the kitchen, cuz, if you can't take the heat. That's what I was told, man. Opinions are like assholes, cuz. Everybody's got one, but I'm going to talk about what the word says, cuz. I'm always going to go by what the word says, and you can hate it, whatever, cuz. That don't matter. You can do whatever you want to, all right? But we need to arm ourselves, and we can stop this, brothers and sisters, okay? I mean, look at what's going on in the world. You got Donald Trump out here freaking just talking all kinds of trash, cuz. I mean, geez, this whole back and forth freaking seventh grade sophomore behavior that him and freaking Kim Jong-un is doing, and that's irreversible, yo. It's irreparable, alright, and it is inevitable for World War III to happen with this, even with that freaking in Pakistan and India and Israel and Iran and all the freaking division here in the United States, okay, between cops and freaking citizens and stuff like that, the rich and the poor, okay, people losing their jobs, just the division all the way around the world. The United States is not united whatsoever, and in a country divided will fall. How are you gonna stay as a country that is freaking daggone built off of the slavery of one race and the freaking genocide of my ancestors, the Native Americans. And I'm a black Indian, if you want to know anything about us North Carolina Indians. Lumbee, you already know, cuz. So, hey, you think you gonna come up in here and you gonna stop anything, yo? Ain't nobody stopping nothing, cuz. Second Amendment rights all day, dog. Protect your shit. Hey, you come around here, you know, these properties right here, cuz, is protected by the good Lord and a gun. And you show around here unwelcome, buddy, and you might meet both of them, son. Do it two times.